I've done it every single year. I've been in Congress with Democratic presidents and Republican presidents, and I really enjoy it. And you know, I do it because it really makes me feel good to participate in the celebration of American democracy. You know, we have a system, obviously, where we elect presidents, and sometimes we vote for the person who wins, and sometimes we vote for the person who loses, and there's no tanks in the street the next day. This is a celebration, the State of the Union. The president reports to the Congress, and so it's great and an honor to be part of it. I was a kid growing up in Bronx, New York, in a working class family. I could have only dreamed that one day I'd be in Congress and be able to attend the State of the Union. It appealed to me 27 years ago when I was a freshman, because you can get on TV shaking the president's hand. But since then, it's taken a different approach. What I noticed, and I didn't realize at the time, was that people in my district would say to me, "I saw you on TV," just constituents. And I would think it was one of these brilliant interviews I'm doing, like the one I'm doing with you now. And I'll say, "Well, what was I saying?" And they'll say, "No, you were shaking the president's hand." And it became obvious to me that people in my district really liked it. And to this day, now I'm one of the veteran members of Congress, I can get on TV all the time, I certainly don't need to shake the president's hand to do that. People in my district still come up to me, you know, average people in the street who I don't really know well, just constituents, who come up and say, "Oh, I really enjoy seeing you on TV, I really enjoy seeing you shake the president's hand," and it's just unbelievable. It's hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people. So now I'm at a point where if I ever didn't show up, people would think something happened to me.